Disney's Christopher Robin opens in theaters, and we've got your review right here. Is it a poo or is it the Winnie? I'm Roth Cornet.
I'm JT.
And let's talk about that Pooh Bear. I gotta say, I had some hesitations going into this film as a diehard Paddington fan.
Oh, okay.
And I felt like there might only be room for one bear in this woman's heart in the movies, and I was very pleasantly surprised. How about you?
Yeah, I missed the Paddington film, so I can't really weigh in on the Pooh Wars. But for me, yeah, I kind of went in this, I was like, the trailers weren't anything like revolutionary. It looked like kind of a something that's been done before. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay, so this is going to be like Hook or some of these other movies where I'm a grown up now and then I rediscover my childhood. In a lot of ways, that's what this movie is. But what really I found interesting was the way Pooh reacted to the real world. And I think Mark Foster does a good job of showing you the real world and then introducing Pooh and his gang to it.
Yeah, I mean, here's my overall thoughts is that unlike Paddington, which I do think found a very clever and unique approach to tell that story, this is a very standard Disney story. It's a very standard Disney film. It follows tropes that you would expect. There are no big surprises. The conclusion that he comes to at the end, Ewan McGregor plays Christopher Robin, of course. And it does follow the trajectory of Hook, where I've abandoned my childhood, I've gotten lost in the workplace, I've forgotten the importance of families, and at the end of the movie, I am going to exemplify the very values that Disney as a brand stands for, right?
Yes.
All of that said, I think within that, Mark Forster's direction elevates the film.
I agree.
I think that, to your point, Pooh as a character is really quite dynamic, and he does embody the Pooh that we remember from childhood, and that he has this innocent quality about him and delivers these pearls of wisdom and these witticisms that really reflect the world around him. And I was so charmed by him, and I was so drawn in by the Hundred Acre Wood and Pooh and Tigger and Piglet and their personalities and what they brought out and what they reflected about Christopher as a man.
Yeah, you know, I want to double up on what you said there. I really think the director brought this weird kind of realism to it that I didn't really expect going in. Like, even Pooh and these guys, they look like these old toys that were dug up and just kind of come to life, whereas certain characters like Al and the Bunny look like just CGI creations of what those animals would be. And the way Pooh interacted with like just society and like things around him, it was in a very realistic manner, and a lot of the humor to me came out kind of like, it's weird, I don't want to compare this to Ted, the Mark Wahlberg movie, but why not the way that bear like interacted with just regular people, everyday appliances and stuff like that, like that added this weird sense of humor to me. And he's such a dry humor Pooh. Like, he says he's like not smartest bear, and he has these ways of like saying things, these little anecdotes that come off cheesy but funny when it's brought into somebody like when you got Ewan McGregor playing off him, and there's the way he interacts with even Ewan McGregor at times, like he has honey on his hand, he just puts his hand on Ewan McGregor's face not realizing the honey's there.
Yeah,
it's just stuff like that I really thought really worked well for me. And the comedy, like, it was funny. It's not crude humor, it's not that humor that's trying to be like in your face. I think sometimes when people go see kids movies, they're worried it's just going to be like maybe fart jokes and just stupid like humor for like physical humor, like somebody falling down.
Yeah.
And there is a little bit of that in this, but it's done in such a like a sweet way.
Sure.
That it kind of worked for me.
It worked for me too. I think that it was shot, we talked about this a little bit earlier. There's a film not everybody loves, Where the Wild Things Are. I happen to be a big fan of that film.
Oh, you were? Okay.
I am. I'm a rare bird in that sense.
It's a beautiful film.
It's a beautiful film, and it's beautifully shot. There were some similar tones here
in terms
of the cinematography. Mark Forster, the director of the film, I think did a really good job with his most important job was capturing Pooh and what Pooh means to us and what Pooh means in the world. And I think a film like this and a character like that does exactly what he's supposed to do. He is alien in this world. It is alien to him. He doesn't understand how it functions. And therefore, his very sincere questions allow us to question, oh, maybe our priorities are off track. Maybe our world doesn't make sense. These are the ways that it doesn't make sense. And we can see that through his lens of innocence, his lens of he sort of accidentally, he makes the mistakes that are the mistakes we should make. He prioritizes what's real. And they're very broad lessons. Again, this is very on brand for Disney. there are some lessons in there that I don't always agree with, where, you know, it's sort of something comes of nothing. On the one hand, on the business side of the equation, they're saying nothing comes of nothing. And then sometimes the very best things come, something's come of nothing. Those are both probably philosophically true, but there is this small part of maybe my adult brain that's like, okay, little girl, Madeline, that's learning these lessons through your father, Christopher Robin, played by Ewan McGregor, you still do need to do something. You know what I mean? I think as a fable for children, that's where I sometimes think, oh, those lessons can be misread.
Yeah, and also this is a family film. Like there are some really sweet moments, and some comedy is really just for families. Where the Wild Things Were, like that movie, I don't know how many kids would actually enjoy that movie. It's you watch it like, this is an adult movie. It didn't really feel like a kids film or a family film. This is something I feel like you bring your kids to, relatives, and they will enjoy it probably just as much as you do, because they're gonna get a little something. There's those silly moments. Tigger is Tigger, like jumping around, just being crazy, and Piglet is so cute with his acorns. And Winnie the Pooh, like I said, it's almost like a dry humor. I kind of compared him to Stephen Wright, the comedian. He just has these deliveries where he's just always monotone. But the things he says are just kind of funny. And he's so innocent in ways that it has this charm to it. And it really kind of won me over as I was watching the movie. Like, you could see Ewan McGregor getting annoyed throughout the movie. But even he is like, this bear is so charming. Yeah. There's a reason why I fell in love with him in the first place.
And it's, of course, voiced by Jim Cummings. And Brad Garrick does some voice work in this film as well. And the success of the film is largely due to how excellent they are in terms of their characterization. Also, the effects. The visual effects are outstanding. Yeah. You really believe the reality of these bears. As you said, even sort of the effects of the honey and how the honey physically works in the world.
There's a gladiator shot. There's a gladiator shot where Winnie the Pooh is like walking through grass.
Yeah.
And there's a close up of his hand like hitting the weeds. I'm like, that's from Gladiator. Yeah. It looks beautiful. And this isn't a Winnie the Pooh movie. I commend him a lot for not taking the easy route of making it look too cartoony. I think the style choice was spot on.
So overall, charming, very good performances, largely driven by Ewan McGregor in the live action portion of the film, but also Hayley Atwell. It is a film with a very standard through line, but one that I think really does work. And I think it is a rare family film outside of the world of Pixar that adults will be as charmed as the kids are, and everyone will walk away feeling a little bit more optimistic. Definitely more optimistic than they felt if they watched Goodbye, Christopher Robin earlier this year, which is a very different version of that human being. This is a fictionalized, Disney-fied version, but it's one that does work.
Yeah, this movie doesn't reinvent the wheel in any way, but I think the style and what the director brought to it really kind of amplified what was good in the movie to make it even better.
And those are our thoughts. I would largely recommend that you go to see this movie. I think that if you are on sort of a limited budget, this is one that may work better for families.
Yeah, matinee.
A matinee, and it may work better for families than if you are an individual adult moviegoer, unless you want to tap back in to that child within.
Yeah, if you're a big Winnie the Pooh fan, if you grew up with it, then absolutely go see this movie.
Those are our thoughts. Let us know yours in the comments below, and we will see you next time.